In this illustration, we intend to calculate the phreatic surface of an earth dam using the Abaqus software. As you observe in the picture, the height of earth dam is 24 meters and the water behind the dam is 12 meters high. In this picture, you observe the phreatic surface having been drawn in the Abaqus software. Actually, we intend to simulate the example 912 from some Helvani book in the Abaqus software. In this picture, you can observe the geometric shape of an earth dam and the permeability coefficient of the earth dam has been supposed to be 0.03 meters per second. I'll enter the Abaqus software for simulation. I'll click on Create Part. Here I intend to create geometric shape of the earth dam. I select the modeling space as two-dimensional. From here, select Deformable and Shell and continue. I'll draw a trapezium. Just according to this shape. The height of earth dam is 24 meters. The size of this side is 60 meters. And the size of this one is equal to 12 meters. I will enter the size of this angle as 45 degrees and done in this manner. As you observe in this picture, the height of water behind the dam is 12 meters. In order to define the surface that will be exposed to the pressure of water, we'll have to create a partition in the model. To do so, I'll click on Tools and Partition, and then Face and Sketch. I'll draw a horizontal line, enter the distance between these two points equal to 12 meters, and done. In the next step, I'll enter Property module, click on Create Material, select Density from General Menu, enter Density equal to 1700 kilogram per cubic meter, select Elasticity and Elastic from the Mechanical Menu, enter Young Modulus equal to 68 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal and the Poisson ratio as 0.3, then click on Other, then pore fluid and permeability, enter specific weight of water equal to 10,000 newton per cubic meter. As explained in the book, the permeability coefficient is equal to 0.03 meters per second and the void ratio is equal to 1. Finally, I'll click on OK. I'll click on Create Section, Continue, OK. Then click on Assign Section, select the earth dam, Done, and OK. I will enter Assembly Module, click on Create Instance, and OK. Then I click on Translate Instance, select the earth dam, Done. First select this point and then this one, and OK. I will enter Step Module, click on Create Step, select the soils and continue. I'll tick off this option. From here I'll select Steady State. In this question, we only intend to study the fluid flow, and we will ignore the formation of earth dam. Therefore, the analysis will be done in linear form, and then I'll click on OK. I will enter load module, click on create boundary condition, select initial step from here, then displacement rotation and continue. I will select the whole of the earth dam, done, and close all boundary conditions for it. Regarding that, we don't intend to calculate the deformation having been created in the dam in this question, and only want to calculate the seepage and the fluid flow inside the soil. So I'll close all the conditions of displacement for it, and OK. Then I'll click on create predefined field, select void ratio from here, and continue. I will select the whole of the earth dam, done, enter the initial void ratio equal to 1, and OK. In the next step, I'll click on create load. From here, select step 1, then gravity, and continue. I'll enter the gravity of Earth equal to negative 10 meters per second square. Click on this arrow, select the whole of the Earth dam, done, and OK in this manner. I'll click on create boundary condition, select pore pressure from here, and continue. I'll select this face, done. We want to define the pore water pressure caused by the water behind the dam. To do so, I'll click on create analytical field. From here, select expression field and continue. As you observe in this picture, the pore water pressure varies with depth in such a manner that it is zero on the water surface and it's 120 kilopascal on below surface of water. Actually, the pore water pressure depends on depth of water and is defined according to this relation, in which H1 is equal to 12 meters, and that is the height of water behind the dam, and omega W is the specific weight of water that is equal to 10,000 newton per cubic meter. Well, I should define the same relation in the Abaqus software. I'll click on this arrow and select this coordinate system. You should note that this relation is calculated based on this coordinate system. Well, I will click on OK. From here, I'll select analytical field 1, enter magnitude equal to 1, and OK in this manner. As you observe in this picture, the earth dam is composed of a drainage blanket at its bottom section, and the width of that is 9 meters, and it is used to control seepage through the dam. I will enter the Abaqus software an intent to define this drainage blanket. I'll enter part module, select datum from the tools menu. From here, select point and then offset from point. First, select this point, enter offset equal to negative 9 meters, 0 and 0. Then select partition from the tools menu. From here, select edge and then select midpoint datum point. Select this line, then this point, and click on create partition. I'll enter load module, click on create boundary condition. From here, select pore pressure and continue. Here I will select this drainage blanket. Done. Allocate the pore water pressure to the drainage blanket edge and OK. I'll enter mesh module, click on assign mesh control, select the earth dam, done. From here, select sweep and quad and OK. Then I will click on assign element type, select the earth dam, done, and put the element family on pore fluid stress from here and OK. I'll click on seed part and enter approximate global size equal to 1 meter and OK. And finally click on mesh part. Here I'll save the model. Enter job module. Click on create job, continue, OK, and click on submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I'll click on result. From here I select the pore water pressure. Here we intend to draw the phreatic surface of the dam. The phreatic surface in the dam is the locus of points at which the pore water pressure is zero. And above the phreatic surface the pore water pressure is negative, and below this phreatic surface the pore water pressure is positive. I will click on contour option in order to draw the phreatic surface of the dam. Then on limits, regarding that the phreatic surface in the dam is the locus of points at which the pore water pressure is zero, so here we should enter the quantities close to zero. Well, here I will enter zero and here 0.001 and OK in this manner. As you clearly observe, the phreatic surface obtained from the Abaqus software and the one referred to in Sam Helvani book are both exactly identical and are actually the same. As already described, the pore water pressure above the phreatic surface is negative. And you can observe here that the pore water pressure is negative. And so all these quantities are negative. And as described, the pore water pressure below the phreatic surface is positive, which can be observed here. And so all these quantities would be positive accordingly.